1 o'clock on a Thursday afternoon in downtown Ciudad Juarez, over the border from El Paso, Texas. Assassins gunned down a victim outside a crowded shopping mall, and their rifle fire also caused a line of other cars to crash. The city paramedics couldn't save the target of the shooting, but they pulled two other drivers out of smashed cars and rushed them to hospital, checking for wounds from the crashes and any stray bullets. As they left the scene, they were escorted by armed police in case any gunmen were still in the area. Shootings like this happen daily in the world's murder capital, where rival drug cartels fight for billion-dollar smuggling routes of cocaine, marijuana, and crystal meth to the US. Since January 2008, there have been more than 5,000 homicides in the city of 1.3 million. Responding to this carnage is a Herculean task for this small team of city paramedics, especially since they don't even have a working ambulance. They have to move in 5 vehicles owned by the Red Cross. With private ambulances staying away from firefights, the team of 8 city paramedics sometimes has to attend to more than 20 gunshot victims in a single afternoon. 34-year-old Lieutenant Carlos Buenrostro is in charge of the 3 p.m. shift. With 16 years' experience on these streets, he is an expert at tending to bullet wounds.
Bueno, nosotros cuando nos dicen que hay una persona lesionada por arma de fuego, no vamos hasta que no esté seguridad por seguridad pública. Es una escena que donde nosotros podamos entrar seguros, ya sea a atender a un paciente que está vivo o a revisar una persona que ya falleció. Entonces, damos seguridad para en caso de que quieran volver a lesionar o a matar a la persona, esta seguridad pública para que pueda protegernos a nosotros.
A dispatcher at police headquarters called in to report a shooting. Buenrostro rushed to the location in the supervisor's car, which can weave through traffic and arrive more quickly than the ambulances. Buenrostro arrived at the scene in a middle-class residential neighborhood. A 50-year-old man had been ambushed and shot in this red Volkswagen. Buenrostro took his vital signs, but it was too late to save the victim. The man had died minutes after the bullets hit.
Te sientes un poco postrado cuando llegas y que no puedes ser el paciente porque te preparas para atender los pacientes, pero hay lesiones que hay pacientes que mueren aunque tú lo traslades vivo por las lesiones, llegan muertos a los hospitales por el mismo trauma que sufren o las lesiones que traen ya.
Buenrostro says the drug gangs have even threatened paramedics, telling them not to attend to certain patients.
Eso nos han amenazado por la radiofrecuencia, que no nos acerquemos a atender cierto servicio. Ellos saben dónde está la persona y te dicen que no te acerques, porque si no te van a disparar, pero te advierten que no te acerques.
Back in 1996, gunmen actually killed a medic when they shot directly into an ambulance to finish off a patient. To avoid more casualties, paramedics now try and have police escorts whenever they are carrying gunshot victims. Buenrostro only attended to one shooting, making it a slow shift by Juarez standards. Jorge Jimenez took over to supervise the night shift, a time when much of the violence usually takes place. A police dispatcher called to report gunfire. Arriving at the scene, Jimenez found that a 16-year-old had been shot in the leg in an attempted mugging. Paramedics had already bandaged up the wound.
¿Por qué te balearon?
Pues nomás porque me quisieron asaltar los tenis. De presente aquí están buenos y salvos y un celular. Lo mejor recomendable es que ya no salgan a las calles con sus celulares.
Most victims of gunshots are taken to the Juarez General Hospital, the city's biggest public clinic, as many private hospitals in Juarez won't accept patients with bullet wounds.
Ya se ha visto casos que llegan y los se meten y lo matan y se van. Por eso los hospitales ya no quieren recibir a personas lesionadas por arma de fuego porque no hay vigilancia en los hospitales.
As a husband and father of two, Jimenez says it is hard in his family to work under such conditions.
Uno está bien porque le gusta su trabajo, le gusta la chamba. Si no nos gustaría, pues a otro lado. Por eso No, ya está, como está feo la situación, pues ya la misma esposa te dice, pues ya búsquete otro trabajo, porque se pone feo a veces. Pero pues aquí estamos.
The shootings show no sign of slowing down. In fact, with the killing of 6 federal policemen at a busy intersection recently, there is fear the cartels will step up their attacks on the government forces sent to restore order. This would make the job of paramedics such as Jimenez and Buenrostro busier and riskier than ever.